I don't mean rhinestones, but diamonds are a girl's best friend. Everybody, I am extremely excited, and before I get into what we're going to be talking about today, make sure that you're going over to patreon.com/AdrianExpression. I just put up an article, I just put up my audio series, I just put up the latest episode of my podcast, The Expression Podcast. Go over there, check it out, let me know what you think. I want to hop right into it, but before we do, I just wanted to talk about the fact that the Birds of Prey trailer dropped, okay, and it looks great. We already know that the premise is the fact that Harley Quinn is ditching the Joker's crazy ass. Even though Harley Quinn herself is a little bit bonkers. But that's fine because we all live for a good team up, and even more than that, we live for some girl power. We can take the conversation a little bit further by saying that I'm going to get my life once Black Canary starts to use that voice. And of course, even her screams sound 100% better than, you know, the types of things that your faves do on stage, right? So I'm very excited to see whatever eardrum splitting nonsense Black Canary has for me. She's yanking these armed men and their hairlines back like she was using a force push. We had no other choice but to stand on that. I don't know what's going on when it comes to DC. I don't know what is in the water. I don't know, maybe somebody changed the air conditioning filter in your building so that whatever was in the air before is finally just being processed out and therefore processed out of your lungs. But if y'all keep this up, DC, just make these movies like this. If the trailer, it matches this movie, girl, we're all going to stand for it. I know you must have asked yourself many times what the people wanted, and this is exactly it. And since we're speaking about what the people wanted Normani, okay? And the people wanted Megan Thee Stallion to come out and to take their high heel boots and just smack the audience across the face with it. The people wanted Megan Thee Stallion and Normani to take their manicured hands and just, you know, move it to right here so that anytime the audience tries to breathe a little bit, they get choked out. That's what I, didn't I say that that's what I wanted to happen in the last video? I said, y'all need to come up here and choke me out. That's exactly, listen to what I'm telling you. That's exactly what they did with this music video. So we'd seen the snippets already. We saw that their outfits were gonna be everything. We saw their looks, we saw the makeup, we saw everything, all right? The only thing that we didn't really hear was a song. I heard it a little bit in the background on one of these Twitter snippets that was, you know, leaked. But when I sat my ass down and pressed play on this goddamn video and that song started playing, I said, yes, ma'am, this is the beat that we wanted. Megan Thee Stallion was riding that motherfucking beat so good. I said, huh? Then she switched up the flow a little bit. I said, what? You know what I mean? I'm confused, girl. Can we run that shit back? I'm like, sis, how the fuck you, how the fuck you speak that quick, Megan? I said, how the fuck you do that shit? Your mouth ain't tired? Bars on top of bars. Just, you know, the flows were everything, giving us the flows that we needed. Then Normani came out here talking about, diamonds are a girl's best friend. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. I said, you've given us real, you know, real pissy. You know what I mean? Real diamonds. She was giving you Marilyn Monroe in the fucking video. Obviously was inspired by Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend. It was just, she looks so good swinging that hoop earring, that big ass hoop earring that she, I don't know which Titan ear she was swinging from Attack on Titan that was wearing a big ass hoop earring, them glittery ass hoop earrings that she was swinging into, but sis, I'm gonna call Captain Levi so he can take care of it. You look good swinging around them big ass hoop earring, giving me Brooke Valentine girl fight tease. Yes, ma'am. Then nobody gonna catch herself popping and twerking and shit and doing choreography. I don't know, titties was just sitting. It's just, it was so disrespectful. I knew I told y'all to come up here and just spit in my face and slap me on my throat and just, you know, tear out my Adam's apple, just rip out my hair from the scalp. I knew that that's what I told y'all to do, but I didn't think that y'all really took it this seriously. But y'all, it was so good. It was so good. And honestly, this is exactly what Don't Call Me Angel wished that it was. You can take the shade how you want to take it. I don't care about it. This is exactly what Don't Call Me Angel, Don't Call Me Gay Boy. That's exactly the energy and the flavor that it wished it had too. I'm so sorry that the seasoning, I'm so sorry that the way the meal prep for this just not transferable. It's just not. Don't Call Me Angel didn't have the required sauce that was, you know, expected in the preparation, you know, in the production of this meal and in this recipe. Sis, it's just, I'm not talking about Cinderella, fairy godmother. I'm not talking about a bibbidi bobbidi boo, sis. When I say that these girls got the magic touch, they got the Midas touch, all right? Everything they touch turns to checks, turns to a hit. We love to see it. I just can't get over it. Like, the set was amazing, the budget was amazing, the hair was amazing, makeup was amazing, dance moves were amazing. They were in there beating up people like they were in a video game. You know what I mean? Megan Thee Stallion was tossing these niggas around. They were beating these people up like they were racist ass Camilla Stans. Hate that for all you mad hoes, but I love that for my two good sisters, Megan and Normani. Please keep slaying us like we know that we deserve that. Something else that we deserve is any communication, any inkling of presence that Beyonce gives to us. And recently she gave us this Adidas and Ivy Park thing that's going to be dropping on the 18th. Alright, she made sure to give us all these promos. Now, Beyonce don't really know what promotion is when it comes to her music, but she definitely does when it comes to trying to sell us these clothing. Alright, you might not want to get her ass up there on that stage or that interview to let you know where to purchase her music, but she's definitely gonna let you know. She's gonna find a way to let you know where to purchase these motherfucking tennis shoes and these sweatpants. That's just it. She did Ivy Park, and what was even more sickening than that, I just, oh my god, when people on Twitter told me that this shit was happening, I said, no, y'all are lying to me, y'all are lying to me. CL, now for those of you who are K-pop stans and y'all already know what the T is when it comes to that shit, CL is an actual beast on stage. Like I said on Twitter, once that microphone is in her hand and y'all start playing that music, CL, she's a fucking international ass superstar when it comes to music, the K-pop industry. The girl, when she hits the stage, listen to what I'm telling you, when she hits the stage, you're gonna pay attention. The girl can perform, all right? So the fact that she was sitting over here starring in Beyonce's new Ivy Park and Adidas advertisement, I said, girl, what did we ever do? What do we ever do to see such a slayage? And I knew that, I told y'all CL needed to leave her goddamn record label. I'm glad that she left that bullshit ass label she was under, or management she was under. These are the type of stars I envisioned CL hanging out with. Not no riffraff, no shade, but I was like, girl, what are y'all doing with this girl? You know, so I'm just so happy to see it. And what would make me even happier is to just imagine that they went into the studio for, even if it was 2 seconds, just to imagine the girls doing choreography together on stage. Can you, I'm getting chills thinking about the lack of hairline, you know what I mean? The lack of skin cells that would be left on that stage once they got through stomping on it, plowing through it with the power of their talent. We love that. I never thought I would ever see no shit like this in my life, but and all they did was take a picture together. Y'all need to collab, make some motherfucking music. Beyonce, since you want somebody to go tour with and shit, you bring your husband around, bring CL around, girl. How about that? This is a really quick side note. I just want y'all to please go stream Yummy, please, so Justin Bieber can stop talking about it. Please, somebody press play on the streaming services. I don't know if you got Apple Music or Spotify, Tidal. I don't know what you got, but if y'all, even if it's on SoundCloud, please stream Yummy. I'm so tired. If Justin don't stop talking about this damn song, he's so pressed. Just discount it like the rest of y'all faves do. Just discount it so you can get the number one. Sell that shit for a cent. I don't know what you're gonna have to sell it for, girl. Like, he's really online, like, oh, please stream it. I don't know, they made a Yummy game too on top of the show. I'm just like, damn, all this promotion ain't helping your ass. Big Justin Bieber sis. I don't know, but like I said, so just so we can all be at peace, please go stream that song. I don't like it, maybe some of y'all will. Justin Bieber will be happy. Finally, he'll stop making all these videos on Instagram to tell y'all to go stream this motherfucking song. God damn, how yummy ain't yummy? We're moving on. Speaking of moving on, apparently I moved right on past this topic when I should have actually spoken about it when it happened, like last video I supposed to have spoken about it, completely forgot to. But Charlamagne apparently gifted DJ Envy a molding of his ass and a little bit of his testicles. And it's just really weird to me. I just don't understand how the people who say some of the most ignorant shit, especially around homosexuality, because you can only just watch anytime a gay nigga comes on their show, it's just like, oh, the jokes start flying. So I don't understand how some of the people say the stupidest shit about homosexuality, about gay people. They end up doing some of the most weirdest shit with each other as straight. Like, I don't understand some of the really alarming shit that y'all have said to gay rappers when they came on your show, but now you got all types of molds of asses and balls bulge and shit, strung up over the Breakfast Club counter. I just make that shit make sense. Charlamagne's always trending for doing some weird shit like this, never for saying anything that's actually beneficial to the community, never. And it's just like, it would be cool if it was just a prank and you niggas weren't homophobic, but like all y'all do some, y'all say some homophobic shit and then do some really gay shit. It's just, I don't know. That's all I have to say on that. So after that whole announcement by Prince Harry and Meghan Markle caught the royal house, the royal family by surprise, Meghan has taken her ass to Canada. She said, good luck. I tried everything that I could have. And if you think that I'm going to take this mistreatment without doing or saying anything, you got another motherfucking thing coming. So she's gone. Prince Harry also did an interview where he said a number of things that caught the media's attention. He said things like, well, I have a family to protect, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. He also said, if people knew the things that I knew, essentially, they'd be doing the same thing. He literally said he's not going to be playing the same game that got his mother killed. It's just like, he's not here for this shit. So he said he's seen this shit before. Like I said in my other video, I was like, I know that's what he's thinking. He's seen this shit before. He can't change what happened to his mother, but he's definitely gonna do everything that he can to protect his motherfucking wife. So I'm here for this. I find it very interesting because now you're seeing the true colors of a lot of media, especially if you're talking about British media. I don't understand, like, y'all were so ready for her ass to go. Y'all were ready for her ass to dip. You didn't want her to be a part of this motherfucking family. And now that she's gone, y'all are mad as hell at that. I don't get it. What they're now, the new approach that they're trying to use, they're trying to say that Meghan Markle is a manipulator, basically trying to call her all types of evil, trying to say that she's using Harry. And the stories on her personality just change with every occurrence. They try and frame her as the villain in every single case, girl. So all I want y'all to do is just make up your mind. Do you want her ass to go or do you want her to stay? And maybe the only reason y'all really have a problem with her leaving is because of the fact that she's taking Prince Harry with her ass. I don't know what y'all thought she was going to. Make up your mind, but either way, it literally doesn't matter because sis is just gonna do whatever the hell she wants to do. Obviously, they're gonna do whatever the hell they want to do because they didn't even let y'all asses know that they were leaving. Love that for us. On that note, check out my Patreon at patreon.com/AdrianExpression. I want to thank you all so much for watching. And make sure that, just like Normani and Megan's accountants, that you have a good goddamn evening.
I'm the librarian, and I came to